Out of the frying pan and into the fire may be the best way to describe Lauren Bobert's decision to leave Colorado's 3rd District and try to run for election in Colorado's 4th District. Not only is she blaming Hollywood celebrities like Barbara Streisand and Ryan Reynolds for forcing her somehow out of the 3rd District, but now she is facing fire directly from her new Republican rivals in the 4th District. And they are coming at her with everything they've got. One of them, Ted Harvey, a former state senator who is vying for that seat being vacated by Ken Buck in Colorado's 4th District, had this to say about Lauren Bobert. Bobert has failed the conservatives in Colorado District 3 to such a degree that they will no longer vote for her. Now, in what can only be seen as a vain effort to cling to power, she seeks to represent the voters of Colorado District 4, a vastly different constituency. This desperate stunt by Boebert may not only jeopardize the Republican Party's ability to retain District 3, but if she were to win the primary, could place District 4 at risk as well. My record is unwavering, he says, and proves my commitment to fighting for limited government, secure borders, the life of the unborn, the Second Amendment, and for citizens who want a representative to stand against the establishment. It's a pretty speech. It's a good attack. But I do have to point out there, Mr. Harvey, that none of those things you just mentioned are actual real issues that are going to change the lives of your constituents. Like, I'm going to fight for the unborn and the Second Amendment. Okay. What are you going to do to help these people economically? Well, I'm going to secure the border. No, actually, you're not. I mean, you're going to pretend you are, but you're actually not going to do anything about it once you get into office. Yeah, you know, a lot of politicians make that claim and then they just literally never do anything. Plus, Colorado is actually very dependent on people coming over the southern border, as is our entire United States economy. So shutting off the border would basically kill the American economy. But Mr. Harvey's not the only one attacking Lauren Bobert. You also have Jerry Sonnenberg running for office. And he says, quote, I look forward to welcoming Lauren to the 4th District and representing her in Congress. I've lived, worked, and raised my family here, and I'm blessed to have always called Eastern Colorado my home. The 4th District is my home, and I'm going to continue to work hard to represent the principled conservative values of everyone who lives here, just as I have always done. Okay, so he's calling her out like, this is my home. I live here. I was raised here. You're just a transplant looking for a congressional seat. Pretty good attack. Then you have State Representative Richard Holtorf, who says, the voters of Colorado's 4th Congressional District want steady conservative leadership from their communities. Seat shopping isn't something the voters look kindly upon. If you can't win in your home, you can't win here. You get the point, right, folks? Lauren Bobert thought she could move from the 3rd to the 4th because the 4th was being vacated by Ken Buck. It's an open seat. Hey, I'll just shimmy on down here and I'll win. And all these Republicans who already had their eyes on that seat are saying, hell no, we're going to take you down. We're going to beat you. We're going to bloody you up as much as humanly possible in this primary to where there's no chance of you winning anything at all ever again. And they're doing a pretty good job of it, too. These voters in Colorado's 4th Congressional District know these people that I'm talking about. They like them. They've voted for them in the past. Lauren Bobert, this seat shopping charge that the last guy, Holtorf, laid upon her, that's a pretty strong one. They're going to label her the carpetbagger. You know, the woman who's just going around district to district trying to find a place where she can win, not because she wants to represent the people, but because she desperately wants to stay in Congress and keep getting that paycheck. So she's got her work cut out for her. And honestly, I don't think she's up for the job. Ring of Fire is just a few subscribers short of hitting that 1 million subscriber milestone. So if you're not already subscribed, please go ahead and do so and stay up to date with all of the latest from Ring of Fire.